Hey, girl. Say hey to the camera.
Hey.
Jump in there, guys. Jump in there, guys. Let me see you jump in. Yeah, big splash. Hey guys, I'm Sunshine from Spooning with Sunshine Homestead, and today I'm gonna do a video that is not like my usual content, but it is very well needed. So I'm here spending some time with my grandkids today, and I decided we're gonna do a video today on something different. Hey, what are we gonna do our video on today, guys?
Pool safety.
That's right. Okay, so to begin the video, let me just say that anytime you have little ones, whether they be grandkids like mine or your own children or nieces, nephews, you know, you're the guardian of some little ones, it doesn't matter. Anytime that you have some little ones and they are around a body of water, whether it be a lake, a pool, a river, a pond, even a bathtub, you want them to be safe in the water. Okay, so I am like a little mermaid myself. I should have been a Pisces, but I am a Gemini. Yeah, Gemini season. Anyway, I love the water. I always have. Hence why I joined the Navy. But it's okay. It's just a fly. It's just a fly. Okay, hold on. So we don't want any tragedies this summer, which is the reason for this video. And with that being said, what I mean by that is if you know how to swim or you know someone that does or you have access to swimming lessons in your area, I advise you all to take advantage of the learning. Take advantage and let someone teach you and your little ones how to swim. Tragedies happen. We have so many tragedies that happen in our country and abroad so many times every year just because little ones don't know what to do if they were to fall into a body of water, and it's just so easy to fix. I'm not a swim instructor by any means. I'm not a licensed lifeguard or anything like that, but I am a first responder, and I have been for 20 plus years, so I guess I'm qualified, and I'm a parent, so I would say that I'm qualified. I taught all of my children how to swim when they were little kids, with the exception of my youngest son, Lathan. He taught himself how to swim because we were always around water in the summertime, and I made sure that they were comfortable around the water because I didn't want any tragedies. I love water, I love the beach, I love pool, and I love baths, long baths. So I wanted my children to be comfortable around the water, and I wanted me to be comfortable while they were around the water. So I taught my children how to swim at a young age, and it's very easy to do. Like, the first thing I would say to teaching them how to swim is to make sure that they are comfortable. Hold on, she's scared of bugs, and I see a bug, hold on. Okay, so the first thing is just to make sure that they are comfortable in the water and by the water, right? Gotta be comfortable, okay? So what I do when they're teeny tiny, like my granddaughter here, hold on, let me let you see. Okay, like my granddaughter here, this is Lauren. Say hey, Lauren.
Hey.
Hey. Lauren is 2, right? How old are you?
2.
2. Yeah, look at you. A cute 2. That's right. And this is Leilani. How old are you, Leilani?
I'm
5. That's right. And Lyric, how old are you?
6.
6. That's right.
So they turn 7 in August.
That's correct.
And you, Rick?
So first and foremost, you need them to be comfortable. So when they are very teeny, teeny, tiny, like say Lauren's age and younger. You want them to be comfortable in the water with you. So their first attempt at getting in some water needs to be with you or with someone that they trust. And I just take my grandbabies this time. I take my grandbaby around with me. I hold her up against my chest.
Mommy.
Hold on, baby. I hold her up. You want your mommy to see you? Say, hey, mommy.
Hey, mommy.
I hold her up against my chest, and we just walk around the pool. We just do circles around the pool until she gets comfortable in the water, and I feel like she trusts me, right? Yeah. And then once they trust me, then I let them get comfortable enough to splash, get comfortable with the splashes going on around them, let them splash themselves so they won't be afraid of the water, because that's the main thing. Kids are usually afraid of the water itself. So once they get comfortable and you can splash them in their face, you know, just take a little splash and splash into their face like that, then that's the first step. I splash their face with a little water. Ooh, look at you being ugly. And then I just let them, you know, the first time I kind of just let them do that alone. That's it. Nothing major on the first day. After they get more and more comfortable with being around the water, then I let them try to stick their face in the water like they're doing right now. All right? And they get curious. Once they get comfortable, they get curious on their own, and they try to do it on their own anyway. So you don't want them to be afraid. So you teach them how to hold their nose, hold their breath, or whatever. You can even use an old trick and blow air into their face and then try to take them under the water. And kids are just like puppies or dogs. Once they get in the water, they will adapt. They will try to swim on their own. Even though they have never been exposed to it before, they will try to do it on their own. You just have to get creative and enhance that. Don't ever want them to be afraid. Anytime they'll be afraid, you just keep ensuring them that they're okay. They're okay. I got you. And that will help them feel more comfortable. Secondly, this is what we do. Come on, let's show them what we do. Okay? I take them. Hold on to the floaty, Leilani. The floaty. Hold on to it. Okay? If you have any type of floaties, I put them in the floaty. And we just take them around the pool. We just take them around the pool like this. Yep. And then we teach them how to kick their feet. Kick your feet, Leilani. Kick your feet. Ooh, that's right. Kick, kick, kick. Kick, kick, kick. That's right. Kick your feet. That's the first thing. And we just go around in circles and circles until they get comfortable. Until they get comfortable. You trying to swim under the float?
Yeah. No, I thought I went under the float by accident.
Okay. Be careful.
And I need help.
Okay.
I screamed.
All right. You got it? You need to hold on to me? You can.
I don't watch.
Okay, so we kick their feet. And let me say, first and foremost, I should have said this from the beginning, but anytime that you're introducing them to the water for the first time, do you see all of these flotation devices that I have on my babies? They can't swim. They have floaties on their arms. They have life vests. They have
life jacket.
Flotation devices that are made especially for toddlers. And this also helps them be comfortable in the water and me as well. Okay? And you just take them out if you want to, little by little, and introduce them to the water by itself and with you. And they kick their feet. Come on, Leilani, show them again. Kick, kick, kick. All right, start them out like that. And after a while, then you can remove the flotation devices if you feel comfortable doing so, and let them do the same thing. And the more you repeat this task, you can even stand next to them and hold underneath their body and let them kick their legs and their arms. Do your arms and your legs, Leilani. like you're swimming. That's right, like a little doggy paddle. That is right. All right. This is what I did with my grandbaby that is over there this morning. And now she is comfortable enough to do cannonballs into the water off of the side of the pool or off of the stairs.
Good job.
Always, always with adult supervision. Never, ever, ever, ever leave the children unattended. I don't care if they can swim better than you. If they are children, do not, let me repeat that, do not leave them unattended. Right? Right, Lauren?
Yeah.
Say, don't ever leave me by myself. Don't leave me by myself. That's right. Always, they should always have adult supervision.
Okay. Watch this.
So, this is my point. All right. You want to show them how you can swim now? I mean, she literally taught herself. Like, I didn't even have to do anything except for teach her the strokes. And she's already going to the bottom of the pool, touching her hands, doing handstands, cannonballs.
I mean,
she's a natural. Okay, let us see. And it's all because she is comfortable in this setting. Comfortable in this setting. That is the key. So, I just thought that I would share that information to help anyone try to avoid any kind of tragedies this summer. If you're out around any type of pools or lakes, ponds, rivers, fishing boats, anything like that, please, please make sure your little ones are taken care of. Please make sure they have any safety devices, flotation devices. What you call them, Leilani? Life vests. Life jackets. Right? Life jacket.
Life jacket.
Life jacket. First and foremost, right? That's right. Make sure. That's right. You can swim. And then once they get it, they got it. And you won't have to worry if you are away from them and they happen to fall into the pool on their own and there's nobody around. They know what to do. They know the basics, at least to be able to swim toward the edge of the pool or swim toward the stairs. That's what I always teach my children. If you were to fall in the pool and nobody was around, try to swim to the edge of the pool or to the stairs, right? That's right. And then they will end up being just like a little puppy. Never taught how to swim, but they do know how to stroke, right, Chico? They yet I do. You remember? I don't know if y'all remember Chico. My baby, he's getting a little cooling off himself. He knows how to swim from the first time I put him in the water. It's hot, and we're facing even hotter days as the summer goes on. So get you all a little cooling off time and some water. But be safe. Be safe. Come on, man. Be safe. This is Sunshine signing out from our homestead. Spooning with Sunshine Homestead. You guys enjoy your Sunday and come back and check out another video.